I think both are important. So we've got a big focus on continuous improvement. So as an example, I'm sure as an individual, you've seen the evolution from cash onto smart cards, onto contactless, and onto Apple Pay. We've taken that same approach, and in our bus operation, we've moved from cash to smart cards to contactless to Apple Pay to a point where a couple of weeks ago, in one of our routes, quite busy routes, we didn't take a penny in cash. It was all contactless. So it's a continuous improvement is really, really important. Another good example would be Office 365. We installed it, we migrated to it 3 years ago, but if we don't exploit it and we don't continuously improve it, then we're wasting our money. So for instance, all my information about projects comes at the moment in Power BI, because instead of traditional spreadsheets and paperwork. But a step change is also very, very important in technology. We, as an example, we launched about 4 months ago something called the Billion Journeys Project. It's an innovation accelerator where we're hoping that we're gonna get a lot of new things and we're gonna be able to pick up some for real. Equally, about 4 years ago, we created a company called OnTrack Retail Limited. With the idea of having our own ticketing and payments engine for rail, which was, I felt that we had to move the step up in digital technology for rail in ticketing, and the only way to do it was by creating a complete new function as opposed to a continuous movement of things. So we've got big focus on continuous improvement, but we need to push on the step change side of things as well. From the top, from the leadership team, we're very, very clear that innovation is important in our world. And we don't delegate that to the CIO or the HR person or any of that. What we do is, as a team, we believe in it and we work with it. So every 2 weeks, we have a meeting as an executive team, which includes our CEO, where we talk about innovation and new things and the transport of the future. Individually, I do believe in technology. I believe in innovation and how it can benefit business. So I help the team. I work with them. If you are in team meetings, you will hear the word "what if" very, very regularly. I push thinking to think laterally. I believe I'm a lateral thinker, and I think it's a great way of innovating, just thinking about things in a slight different way. But also, it's in our DNA. We've always, for years, we've really tried to be first in when it comes to innovation. From we have the only bus depot in the UK which is fully electric. And we've pushed our carbon our savings in carbon from 10% target to 21% in the last 3 years. So we believe in innovation and we try to push it. My job is about strategy and it's about innovation and it's about the technology and the transport of the future. That's what I should be doing, and obviously people leadership. For BAU. BAU can really get in the way of this if not careful. It's very, very easy to go back into business as usual. It's extremely easy. So for that, the trick is having a really, really strong team. I believe, and I do sincerely believe, that if I don't recruit people better than me, then I'm not doing a good job. And they should be looking after business as usual as well as innovation. But it should be, I should not have to spend much time in business as usual. With regards to legacy, it's a difficult one because it's sometimes it's difficult to get out of your legacy applications. We tend to do roadmaps and be very, very clear how can we get out of these things eventually. And then we put aside a bit of money every year to spend in getting out of legacy, yeah. I think the CIO role, little by little, is becoming part, an integral part of any executive team. So to the point of, it's probably a bit too early, but in the last 5 years, in the next 5 years, I think it's going to become, we're going to start seeing CIOs accessing boards of directors. Traditionally, these boards of directors have been very traditional, audit kind of oriented, full of finance people. I think that little by little, we're going to see more and more of my peers going into board jobs, because it's becoming more integral to the whole business. So it's not just it's everyone in general is starting to realize how important technology is becoming in running a business. There are two things that get me really, really excited in Go Ahead. The first one is the international expansion, because I come from an international background. All my career, I've been working in international environments, and I think that we've got a great, great opportunity. We move a significant percentage of the transport in a very complicated city like London. This is recognized abroad. We now have presence in Singapore, another really complicated city. We're doing really well over there. We're doing well here. I think that we have a lot of room for expansion in internationally. And I'm really excited to support that and to push it with the rest of the exec and be part of that journey. The second one is something we call hammock. So about a year ago, I realized that as a company, we are really, really good at ticketing and payments. I've mentioned it earlier, we've been first in very many areas, and I believe that we do projects in ticketing and transport really, really well. And just to put it in perspective, the whole of the ticketing and the payments that we manage, that my team manage and develop, would be larger than the whole of New Zealand or the whole of Ireland. So we kind of know what we're doing. And based on that, we believe that we can sell those services to third parties. And we've created a small diversification. It's small at this stage, but we're gonna try hard. A small diversification item called Hammock, which is a consulting business. We believe we can help people out there, especially abroad, with ticketing and payment initiatives.